may be won, but here at Craven Park, there's plenty at stake for Hulkingston Rovers and Bradford Northern on this final day of the league season. For Rovers, there's a premiership spot to play for. They're fighting with Halifax and Castleford for the last two places in the top eight. Northern still have faint hopes of second place if St Helens and Wigan both lose. In any event, they need at least a draw to be sure of a home tie in their premiership opener. So today is important.
We slipped up earlier on in the week, but today, if we win, we're going to clinch a place in the premiership, which is sort of vital for the club, I think.
How G'd up are the players?
Oh, very much so. They're all determined to do well. You know, our last home game of the season, and we want to do well for the crowd, really.
You've always had ding-dong tussles with Bradford Northern, haven't you?
That's right, yeah. They seem to be a bit of a bogey team for us, but we always seem to come out when it matters, really.
Paul, nice to be back on old familiar territory. A very important game for you.
Very important for Premiership, but also we lost last week against Wigan, so we've got to pick up again for Premiership.
Now, you've had many happy years here at Craven Park. Are you surprised to see Hull KR struggling to get into the top eight?
I am, really, because there's some marvellous players. I've got a lot of good friends here, but like I say, injuries have knocked them back a bit. But they're still a good side. They beat all the top six here this season. So we've been our job today. There's 13 on the park, and that's what it's all about.
And there's a nice moment. The Hulkingston Rovers chairman, Colin Hutton, presenting Gordon Smith with a memento to mark his long service with Hulkingston Rovers. This is his final match here, and Rovers will certainly miss especially his versatility. And he proves it today. So often a loose forward, there he is at number seven. Rovers without eight first-teamers. The long-term injured include Mike Smith and George Fairbairn, and Zoukema's on fire service duty. So the reshaped lineup includes four hookers, and there's a debut in the second row for 17-year-old Paul Fletcher. Northern arresting teenagers Neil Roebuck and Paul Rhodes, though Rhodes is on the bench. Heath Godfrey starts the match at standoff, where he played a sub last week. And an interesting character at loose forward, Alan Clarkson, playing his first Division 1 game in 13 years. Here now, David Watkins and John Hell.
Well, Alan Clarkson was telling me before the kick-off how thrilled he was to be making an appearance in the big time again. He's the landlord of the office pub in Bradford nowadays. That takes up a lot of his time, but he still loves the game of rugby league. It's a first appearance at Craven Park in a senior match for our referee today, Kevin Dockery of Leeds. And the pitch looks like a drunken impression of the Olympic flag, but those are imprints left by a sprinkler, I assure you. And Rovers in the red and white strip get the game underway. And it was Harkin, the former Hull KR man, who fielded it and gave it to Phil Ford, one of those men who is on the plane to Australia. And Clarkson gets his first touch of the ball. Obviously wanting to get involved early. No ball to Hill. And Hull KR at home, a very good record indeed. It's been dented recently with two defeats. And Bradford moving very slickly down that touchline. Simpson trying to improve that away record of theirs. They've won eight and lost only three away from home. So encouragement early on here for Bradford. Harkin flinging the long, long pass out for Hobbs. And still he's kept it going with that lovely back flip. Heath Godfrey back inside. Francis. And an astute kick from Harkin. And a lot of people, David, feel that Paul Harkin was an unlucky man not to be selected for the tour.
Very unlucky. He's been very impressive. He's a good scrum half. He's a durable guy, and I would have thought would have been a real candidate and should have gone to Australia.
Barry Seaborn there in the overcoat has done an extremely good job as the coach over the last three seasons. So Gordon Smith has the put in, and he dives on the ball as well. Rovers have a chance in possession with their loose forward Speckman, and a penalty is given against Bradford Northern. The crowd perhaps a little affected by Rovers' midweek defeat at Hunslet, but they're still making a noise, and they will if Rovers can get on the scoreboard. Gary Clark, here's the hooker Harrison, Smith's ball for Burton, and a very good tackle indeed by Clarkson, who's been brought in to do that job. Then Clarkson in on the tackle, and Parker. And Des Harrison plunging, and McGowan having to really hold on to him there. He made some good yardage that time, Harrison. Smith, longer ball, Speckman, and this is neat movement, and very good, and Laws just caught by the ankle by Francis, otherwise he looked a certain scorer. And here's the drop attempt, and it's not a good one, well fielded by Ford. It was an awkward one for Phil Ford. Fairbank and Simpson. Keep it moving is Fairbank, and he does. Oh, and he's thrown it straight into the hands of LKR man, David Watkinson. Well, that was unfortunate for Bradford, especially inside their own 25. And they're roaring up here. Well, it was Gary Sims, the young centre here, who's had a couple of seasons in the A team and getting a rare run out in the first team. And once more, the penalty has been awarded. The Rovers on the ball, and Gordon Smith's looking it short for young Paul Fletcher there, number 12, and it's his third game in 3 days. He's played with the Colts, then the A team, and now the first team, so he's a fit young man. And Des Harrison flings it out. Speckman keeps the move going. Bradford's tackling has to be good here. Gordon Smith, and he missed Watkinson, did Clarkson then. He's got him the second time. And that time it's a lovely ball from Smith to Speckman, who's looking very dangerous close to that Bradford line. And here's Gordon Smith again. He's seen so much of the ball. A useful kick from Parker. And it's going to bounce awkwardly, maybe. Simpson just getting his fist to the ball, with Steve Smith coming up on the outside. Bradford having to defend, but that is one of their stronger points.
Yes, they are defending well, but what enterprise the Hull KR side is showing. They're knitting together quite well, despite all the changes in the programme, and are really putting up a first-class performance.
And there's Mumby's dropout, and it's got good distance, but it's well taken by Laws. And he kicks straight at Mumby. It might yet fall for Hull KR. Clarkson has got Harrison when it mattered most, and the Rovers fans really roaring their team on here. I think they know that Roger Millwood has had a lot of injuries to contend with. When you think that not at Roger Millwood's disposal today, names like Fairbairn, Fletcher, Mike Smith, and the three from down under, Ryan Taylor and Mortimer, plus Zouk Emma, who's on fire service duty this afternoon. Feeling that these two teams are keen to impress on television as well. Godfrey ducked under the tackle of Speckman, but it's the last tackle. Bradford only just inside the Rovers half as Harkin again kicks for touch, and this time straight into the hands of Steve Smith. He'll get away from Francis, and he'll get away from Godfrey, and he'll get away from the next man, and he gets away from McGowan. Oh, brave running from Smith. turns the ball back inside for Sims, and he'll get a good round of applause for that one, Steve Smith. That was classic wing play from Smith.
Well, they are really impressive. They're moving the ball about well, and they're playing with a new sort of spirit, which Roger will be undoubtedly happy to see this at the end of the season, ready for next year.
But Noble gives the break, and Fairbank streaks away. Can he get under the post? Fine tackle. Noble got the interception, set Fairbank going, and he's had to dive on the ball now, but it's back to six tackles for Bradford. 5 yards out. Harkin, Hobbs, here's Brendan Hill, all 18 stone of him. So a real chance for Bradford to get the first try now. As Harkin gives it back to Skerritt. And it's Rover's turn to defend. And Fairbank looked for the world of scorer then when Noble got him away. Harkin, well, he fooled Laws. But he didn't fool the young man in the second row, Paul Fletcher. Godfrey, and a lot of options here for Bradford. Fairbank must keep it moving. Heath Godfrey keeps it going. Mumby, he'll get it away. Phil Ford, the heel jink this way, that way. And on the last tackle, there could be a drop at goal, or Ford might still keep them going. Oh dear, right under the sticks. And Carl Fairbank fancied the first drop goal of his career. It would have been, but it didn't come off. Well, matches between these two sides usually produce an abundance of points. It's not been the case so far today, but it's not a bad game for all that.
Well, it hasn't lacked anything. It's had excitement. We've nearly had tries scored at both ends, and of course the tackling and the passing has been exceptional.
Well, this is the way the scrums are going. 4-1 by Hull KR, and Brian Noble yet to register on the board. Not one against the head. Bradford, and Ford times his ball to Godfrey, and McGowan gets Simpson moving, and there's a man on the outside, Francis Simpson, deciding to come infield. And Bradford are looking very quick when they're on the move. There's Clarkson getting inside the 25, and Mumby, as always, willing to come up in the line. Harkin, beautifully timed pass for Hobbs, and David Hobbs, surely he's there. David Hobbs is in for the first try of the afternoon. And here's a fella who could have been going to Australia. But Harkin again did the damage.
Well, both sides have been very close, but this is Paul Harkin, a long pass taken on the burst by Hobbs, who didn't have to look outside him, goes over for a try, most important one of that.
And it'll be David Hobbs who'll attempt to convert his own try. David Hobbs just registering there his fifth try, and they've all come in recent weeks. He's disappointed not to be adding to that list of Great Britain caps. And he's been in good goalkeeping form recently as well. It's not an easy one, this. Got to curl it round, and he curls it well, but just too much, in fact. So 4-0, Bradford Northern are in the lead, and it's that man who's given them that lead. But there was no way he was going to be stopped once Harkin gave him that pass.
Well, Bradford been down here once before, didn't score, but this time a long ball out to Hobbs, leaves him away, takes the fullback out of it, and what a try.
Clarkson, and that's a good ball as well, and Fairbank's racing away. Noble's up here, Simpson alongside him, and Roger Simpson sprints for the line, gets it back. Fairbank's 2-3 yards out. Good movement again from Bradford, and they look absolutely determined to get in. And Richard Francis, yes, he's done it. Richard Francis wriggles his way. Oh, he hasn't, I thought he had. Well, the referee fooled me because he pointed as though he was giving a try. And they're queuing up here for the pass. Well, that was baffling. It looked for all the world as though Francis had been awarded the try. Hobbs. Last tackle, though. So it's got to be this one, or not at all. And Skerritt's not going to make it, I don't think. No, and it's the handover. few complaints there from one or two Bradford players who felt a chance was spurned. There'll be another penalty against Bradford for offside. I really thought that Francis had got there.
Well, he deserved a try because the backing up was superb and it had covered something like 50, 60 yards going through a four or five pair of hands. But the referee thought otherwise.
Well, the penalties, Bradford have conceded six of the first eight. Smith, though, and Burton couldn't take the pass, and so Mumby has the opportunity to set Bradford in motion, giving the pass to Godfrey. Ooh, and that's a head tackle, all right, by Burton on Clarkson, who looks flat out. And the trainer is sprinting on, and Alan Clarkson was perhaps wishing he was back in his pub.
Well, that was a high tackle, and Chris has always has a habit of doing these in games, and more certainly both the linesman and the referee will certainly make the most of this, but I mean, it really has caught him well.
And what it has done is given Bradford another opportunity here, a few yards out. They're an awkward team to play against the Northern, and they're looking the right mood today. They've five more tackles in which to conjure up a try. First man in will be Brendan Hill. Noble, Clarkson, Harkin again for Hart, and they're not going to stop him again. And this time he's straight under the sticks, and it's the same old combination, Harkin and Hobbs.
Well, Bradford have to make the most of this again. They're attacking, and Harkin again, and there's that man Hobbs on the burst. He's got a point to prove, and my gosh, he's proven it.
Well, at the risk of repeating myself, Harkin and Hobbs might well have been a good combination to have been in Australia. But David Hobbs here has the chance of registering Bradford's 10th point, and he's got all 10 of them.
Well, both players are worthy. They were tour candidates in my book and were for a lot of other people, and I think perhaps they might feel rather unfortunate, to say the least, of being left out of the tour to go to Australia.
Here again we see how well they work in harness.
This is again a Bradford Northern move, and Harkin coming across. Look how Hobbs runs from depth. He knows he's going to get there, and he gets there.
Oh, and Fairback gave the ball back neatly there for Noble. Skerritt, yes, he passed his man away off Noble's pass, and he's looking for Ford on the outside. We'll keep it going with Mumby instead. Ford still looking for the pass. But it's all enterprising stuff from Northern, is this. Harkin again there, and Hobbs, and Harkin's made the gap himself, flings the ball out for Roger Simpson, screams for a forward pass, not given. And last tackle once more. Phil Ford's calling for the ball. He probably fancies a drop attempt. Harkin, ooh, that's not a good ball, though. It's going to come to Ford, who's going, and Phil Ford might just make it all the way himself, and he's got Brendan Hill over. Intelligent play from Ford again. He saw the gap, he spotted the opening, he knew the big fella would be at his side, and when Brendan Hill's coming your way, you know you've not got much chance of stopping him.
Well, Bradford's teamwork is superb, and they move the ball out again, a long speculative pass which bounces, and Ford picks it up and intelligently now goes straight. But good backing up by Brendan Hill allows him to take the pass, and who can hold him back?
And it's a very good psychological time for Northern to get that third try of the half. A minute from the hooter, and if Hobbs pops this one over, as he should do. No, how on earth did he miss that? Well, he can't believe it. Well, I'm sure he can't either, and it keeps the scoreline at Hull KR 0. Bradford Northern 14, it really should have been 16. But Brendan Hill is really unstoppable in this sort of mood.
Well, Bradford's teamwork has been the key factor, and although it's a long speculative pass, Ford picks it up, does the right thing, goes straight, draws the defence, and then Hill has the sense to follow him up, and there's no stopping him.
from the restart. McGowan knocked on 5 yards out, so his colleagues won't thank him for that. And I suppose there's a chance here for Rovers, who could have been 16-0 down, to make it 14-4 instead, as Gordon Smith tries to burrow his way almost underground. But there, Northern have held out, and so it's Northern who go in 14 points to the good, and they've just been a little bit too, Julie, involved in rugby league. It's in fact an actor who's talking now with Nick.
That's right, John. In fact, it's Nigel Betts who's starring in Up and Under, the well-known rugby league play, which has been a great success in London. It opens again in Hull on Tuesday night. Nigel, you're a rugby union man. What have you made of this?
Well, originally, but it's a bit of only a bit of a different game. It's just two players less, but I like it. It's a good, been a good sort of open running match so far.
Now, you should be supporting Hull Kingston Rovers here, and they're being played off the park.
Well, yeah, it's a few disappointing mistakes here and there, but yeah, they're doing not too bad. They're keeping them out, I think. So that's some good sort of defensive bits down there, but yeah, and just seem to be going through them.
And have you learned something?
Oh yes, well, they're a bit bigger than the lads that we've got in the play, like, but I think they've been training a bit longer than we have.
Nigel, thanks very much indeed. Good luck with the play. And incidentally, there's more rugby league drama in Channel 4's film on Thursday. That's Dennis Waterman starring in the story of the Australian tourists of 1908, the first kangaroos.
Quite attractive.
Do you have any pictures of yourself, Mr. Goldsall?
Have you fallen in love, Mr. Giltonen?
The fastest thing on two legs, Dally Messenger.
The next 40 minutes, as play resumes, and David Laws makes a catch under his own sticks. Now, it's important, David, for Rovers to get on the scoreboard early.
Yes, it is, because no doubt Roger will have said that they did a lot of enterprising stuff first half, but didn't cross or gain through the Bradford defence. And it will be important that in front of their own fans, and of course that they do score a couple of tries.
Well, in the first half, the scrums went Rovers' way, 6-3. None were won against the head by other hooker. But the penalties going very much against the visitors. They've conceded 8. And just 3 errors in play by each side. That's very, very low. And very commendable. Ford always manages to get that ball away in the tackles he's done here to Mumby. And again, good interplay between Harkin and Noble. And I would think the Bradford contingent will be quite delighted with the way the game's gone so far. Stone of Brendan Hill once more, still knocking them away, giving the ball for Fairbank, and coming up on the outside is Francis. Oh, what a good tackle as well. Excellent tackle by David Laws, as Francis would have been a certain scorer. That was thrilling rugby. First of all, you had to admire the attacking and then the defending of the fullback.
Yes, sir, Brendan, this is where he's good at. He can pull 2 or 3 into the tackle, still get the ball go. And Fairbank there, giving the form that we all hope he'll have in Australia this summer.
The ball's coming out for Bradford, and Harkin wriggles away. Oh, and Harkin's over himself. Oh, yes, that was clever. Well, Paul Harkin will have really enjoyed that, to come back to Craven Park and score a try against his old club, and he did it all himself.
Well, they made the most of it here. Just look the way he wriggles out of a tackle. The dummy leaves the defence standing. A brilliant try.
A happy day for Harkin. Well, David Hobbs has missed a simple kick just before half-time. But he's got it right this time. And Northern go on to 20 through the boot of David Hobbs. Harkin for Mumby. Oh, and a sidestep from Mumby. Oh. Great run from Mundy as well. Terrific stuff from the former Great Britain fullback. Well, people have always talked about his defensive qualities, but he's still as good a fullback as there is in the game. But I really do feel that Keith Mumby is unlucky not to be going to Australia.
Well, one can only hope he might still make that trip, because of course Hampson has broken his arm, and this fella plays as well as anybody who can play at fullback.
Bradford just looked that little bit quicker as Simpson gets Ford ticking. Now, what's Phil Ford going to do this time? Well, he's still there, and he's still got that ball away. And Hill, beautifully timed ball for Carl Fairbank, who races past the fullback. And that's just the sort of form that will encourage Carl Fairbank on his way to Australia. Again, Hill did the damage.
Bradford's teamwork, always keeping the ball moving. It's never dead in Bradford's hands, and they know they've got to get as many points on the board as they can. Ford holds it up. Hill charges in, takes two out. Look at that superb pass up. And Fairbank thinks, my gosh, I'm in Australia already.
And there are two more points from the boot of David Hobbs. And Bradford Northern now moving into an emphatic lead. It's 26-0. Well, Noble has been pulling the scrums back. Only one in it now as the ball goes in, and it's out on Northern's side again. And here's Phil Ford timing the pass for Godfrey and Mumby now. And surely McGowan is going to get Simpson over. It's try number six for Bradford Northern. And Roger Simpson, who scored in the home win over Rovers earlier in the season, is a very happy young man. 30 up for Bradford.
Well, Bradford, big men in the scrum, get the ball out, and they're making a habit, and this is good teamwork, and that's what it's all about. They know they've got this Hull KR side at sixes and sevens, and Simpson's away for another try on the outside.
Well, it was super slick Simpson there. That's his fifth try. And David Hobbs strangely missed the simplest kick he had after Brendan Hill's try. And right out on just a few yards in from touch, he puts boot to ball, swirls it round, but it's offline. So it remains Hull KR 0, Bradford Northern 30, and it's a little bit of an embarrassment for the home club.
Well, Bradford's teamwork has never been under question, and yet again it's highlighted by the fact that they move the ball quickly. They spread the defence wide, and Simpson's left with the easy task of rounding his man for a try.
It's all going Bradford's way, and Ford nearly fumbled the catch and sets off himself through the middle. And who'd dare go against Phil Ford on a day like this? He might just go all the way himself. This is extraordinary from Ford. It's remarkable. He's gone, well, I think he wanted to go all the way himself. And eventually it fell into the hands of Hull KR man Sims. But, well, that was Phil Ford at his most eccentric and exciting.
What a run, what a run. Left defender after defender in his stride. But that's the sort of exciting player he is. He wants to come in field. He's always looking for work. And I've no doubts at all that down under this summer, he'll be a hit.
Bradford coming looking for another score, and they might just get one as here from Hill. They just can't stop him. Well, I think he got it wrong. He put one finger in the air, but he's got two tries. And Bradford's power in the pack and the sleight of hand of Harkin is destroying Rovers now.
They really are driving it home now to a side like Hull KR were totally demoralised, and my lucky Jubos in, takes two men out and in for a try, and he's a happy man.
And it's also a happy Hobbs, he'll keep potting those over all day. and certainly adding to his career tally of goals. 36-0 Bradford Northern's lead.
Moving the ball, taking it on the burst every time. This has been a hallmark of the side. Pushes men over and completely shatters the defence, Brendan Hill.
Two tries for him. And Bradford must be thinking of running up a record score here at Craven Park. The way things are going now, Mumby. Northern just seem to have had all too much power for Rovers.
Well, they've played well as a team. Their tackling has been superb and their backing up and running with the ball has really spread the defence of Al-Kayar and scored tries at will.
Oh, but now the ball goes to ground from Hill and a chance there for young Sims. Hill's first mistake of the match, I would suggest. Ooh, and Parker just taking that by the bootlaces. Now he's lost the ball and Fairbank gets away. Both sides doing their best to give the ball away, but to be fair, there have been so few errors in play in this match, it's got to be commended. Nice movement of the ball again, and Hobbs gets Godfrey the pass, and Mumby looks for the gap as he might pierce. And yes, Godfrey's at his shoulder once more. Bradford seemingly getting the ball away in every tackle, and they're roaring forward now with Fairbank. And just, oh, Fairbank's going to go all the way himself. He's done it all himself. There's a disconsolate race stood on the ground. Fairbank registers his second try. And Bradford's pack is altogether much too powerful for Rovers.
Well, they're doing everything at will. They've got the ability to get the ball out of the tackle. The man never goes down to the ground without releasing the ball. Fairbank, the backing up again. And this Hull KR side must be sick and tired of seeing people running at them with a power and aggression like this fella is scoring on.
Anybody watching in Australia might have been a little bit frightened by the sight of Fairbank on the burst there, bearing in mind he's on the tour. So the scoreline after Fairbank's try, Hull KR still nil and Bradford Northern 40. And we do hope that our viewers down in Australia are enjoying Scrum Down. The programme has been watched all around the world and these are the sort of tries they've seen.
That's right, it's the backing up. Everyone there to a man is just taking the ball right, releasing it at the right time and running at speed, and that's important, leaving the defence spread eagles and going in for a try.
And here comes Mumby again. He's off in the mainspring. Gratian. McGowan's turn to run. Clarkson, and now McGowan. He's not going to try yet, but he's got a few this season. 11 to be exact. Bradford just getting that ball away, seemingly in every tackle. Godfrey skips past his man, kicks ahead. Heath Godfrey! This could be an extraordinary try by him. It was one of the quicker men on the field, Sims, who got back to deny him. Heath Godfrey, who's come into the side today in place of young Neil Roper, has done a good job.
Yes, it gives them the confidence, doesn't it? When you're scoring tries at will and you're backing up and playing together as a team, you have that much more confidence in your own ability. And that boy there coming into the side knows that he's in a side that's playing well and he's prepared to try just about anything.
Phil Ford. Extraordinary that Bradford have got so many tries without Ford getting one as he skips away. Of course, we saw Witness register 66 last week at Hunslet. I don't think Bradford are going to top that. But Hill just will not lie down. Oh, Arkin, and Hobbs comes up for his hat-trick, is he? Oh, he's a yard out, he's got his head up against the post. And I think it's going to be a scrum, it is. But Rovers, well, they must have sore heads as well. In fact, there is one player down by the posts. There is Ray Stead. Well, Bradford's got the ball from the scrum, and Harkin is in again. So simple. You feel a bit sorry for dejected Rovers. He almost apologises, does Harkin there. Oh, dearie me, he said. Sorry about that. And he's another man with two tries to his name.
Yeah, it's a good pass on the base of the scrum. Sells the dummy and goes over. He now knows it's easy.
Well, it's end of the season. Testimonial stuff is this. Well, Hobbs has missed one kick under the sticks. Surely he can't repeat that. And it's turned into a real old hammering for Rovers. That kick makes it 46-0. And David Hobbs, five goals, two tries. Harkin there, two tries.
Another scrum, a player down injured. Harkin's got it, captain's part, sells the simplest of dummies. Rattles up the score.
And the awful thing for Rovers there was that about three Bradford players could have scored the try. They were all in for it. Now it's at times like this when everybody wants the ball. Gratian, he's as big as his dad, Jeff. Still has that ambition to play alongside his son in First Division rugby, might achieve it next season. For such a big fellow as Hill is, he just never stops running for 80 minutes.
He doesn't, and he does. He's got one good thing, which he can get rid of the ball in the tackle, and that's so important. I would have thought it would have been even more important out in Australia.
Hobbs makes the break, and now they can't stop him, but Clarkson spills the pass, but at least he made the tackle as well. Alan Clarkson really enjoyed himself coming back into the team. Can't be about it, he'll be telling people in a few years' time, well, I only played one game for Bradford Northern and we went into a 46-0 lead. Time to add to that as well, with 10 minutes left. Oh, the pass is put down and now Francis can't get past his man, but he does make a good tackle. Rovers will have another six tackles. Harrison runs into Fairbank and Simpson, and he almost lost the ball, and now he has lost it. Francis has got it back to Bradford, who'll be looking to take their tally to 50 now. Gratian offloads to Noble. Four more tackles. And again, Harkin at the hub of it, and Mumba sprints away. Looks for Phil Ford on the inside. Phil Ford gives it to McGowan, and he puts it down. And that was one where I'm sure Mumba might well have scored himself if he'd gone all the way.
Well, this is exhibition stuff now by Bradford Northern. They know it as well, and they are playing and throwing the ball about with gay abandon.
And the Rovers supporters generally unhappy.
It says much for them that they've stayed this long, and that's... means that they're showing their appreciation of this Bradford side who've played remarkably well.
Now Phil Ford skips left and right and then gives it into Burton's hands. Oh, and Smith has kiddied them and he's away down the touchline. Steve Smith chased by Simpson. Oh, great tackle as well. And that shows a lot to Bradford's character. Even at 46-0, they want to get back and stop the opposition scoring.
Well, their defence has been quite superb, and that shows just what professionals they are in this Bradford side. There was no way we were going to allow Alcaraz to score them.
They might get one here, though, still, and the ball surely must end up over the line. That is a try on his debut for Paul Fletcher, 17 years old. Well, it's a nice way for the young man to round off... a sequence of three games in 3 days.
Well, they've been most disappointing, Hull KR. They nearly scored then when the winger got away. They moved the ball out wide and they caught Bradford napping in the middle. Look, there's four or five Bradford players all under the post, but long balls out to the wing. And there he is going in for his try. What a lovely try.
Hardly an easy kick to try and put over. And it's a little bit flat, and so there's no conversion, and indeed there goes the hooter, and a really comprehensive victory for Bradford Northern. They've really annihilated Hull KR to confirm their placing in the top four of the Stonesbitter Championship, and there they are. They've a right to be jubilant, not just because of today's performance, but because of an excellent season. They surpassed everybody's expectations and are worthily in the top four of the championship. So, in a nine-try performance, there were two for Hobbs, two for Hill, two for Harkin, two for Fairbank, one for Simpson, with five goals from David Hobbs. And just at the death, a try for Hull Kingston Rovers from Paul Fletcher. The man of the match is down in the Bradford Northern dressing room now with David Watkins.
What a way to finish Scumdown on, seeing Bradford justify their position in the league with a scintillating display of rugby at Craven Park this afternoon. Many tries and great individual performances, and Bradford must feel aggrieved with only having two members of their side going on tour to Australia. Yes. But for me, the man of the match, without any doubt this afternoon, for his power play and offloading the ball in the tackle, was Brendan Hill. Yes. Stone's better man of the match award and the £100 cheque. Congratulations.
What's going on with the bar?
Office bar.
You enjoyed it?
Yeah. Well, we've all worked hard this season to get what we've got. Let's hope we can carry on into Premiership. This is for all lads as well. All right, thank you.
Well done.
In a one-sided contest, the strangest fact is that Rovers actually won the scrums 9-6. But crucially, Bradford's Brian Noble won two against the head. There was quite a gulf, though, in the penalty count. Roger Millwood's boys only gave away five. Bradford Northern conceded 13. It was a flowing game, a few errors. Again, surprisingly, though, Bradford committed just one more than the opposition. But it won't come as a shock to anyone that Bradford had more possession. They kept the ball for just under 5 minutes more than Rovers. Now let's see how the rest have fared today. Nick has all the results.
First, the Stonesbitter Championship. Castleford 26, Leeds 12. So Castleford clinched their Premiership spot, but Paul Medley of Leeds suffered a recurrence of a neck problem, which might be a worry for the tour to Australia. Hull Kingston Rovers 4, Bradford Northern 46, which means Rovers missed the Premiership, and Northern will open with a home tie against Leeds. Lee 31, Hull 9. The veteran Harry Pinner inspired Lee to a convincing win, but they're still relegated. Salford 36, Halifax 16. Two more tries here for Peter Williams, boosting his chances of touring down under after only a handful of rugby league games. St Helens 52, Swinton 4. Kevin McCormack got two tries, and so did Mark Elia, as Saints crossed the visitors' line 10 times. Wigan 62, Hunslet 10. Mark Preston, another recent rugby union convert, ran in five tries, as Hunslet conceded 60 for the second week running. Division 2. Barrow 32, Wakefield 16. Carlisle 16, Oldham 34. Dewsbury 42, Sheffield 16. Featherstone 64, York 10. Fulham 9, Springfield 8. Huddersfield 14, Runcorn 16. Workington 13, Rochdale 4. There's the final championship table. Widnes finishing 4 points clear. St Helens have edged Wigan and Bradford Northern out of the runners-up spot, only on points difference. At the bottom, Salford's win today keeps them up and sends Lee down with Swinton and Hunslet. In Division 2, Featherstone pipped Wakefield for the second place by winning today. Both go up with Oldham the champions. And lower down the table, no doubt that Dewsbury have been the team of recent weeks, a remarkable revival to lift them out of the bottom five. And the top try scorers at the close of the championship, Martin Afire 11 clear of last year's winner Ellery Hanley. Gary Schofield and Carl Gibson flying the lead flag there. And he could weigh the top scoring forward, and Kevin Pape, the leading try scorer in the second division.
So now we come to the big moment, the result of our try of the season competition. Well, we've certainly had some marvellous tries, and thank you for the entry. It was a very good entry as well. Now, David, you had the difficult task of judging this competition. What were you looking for?
Well, individual tries are usually the result of good teamwork, good passing and vision by support players, and I was looking for a bit of all of that, and I feel that I've got the right combination in the tries I've chosen.
OK, well, let's have a look again at the three winning tries in reverse order.
In third place, Kevin Iroh for Wigan. A brilliant individual try.
Well, this is where Widnes' defence will really have to be on its toes. And Widnes lose the ball when they most needed it to give Wigan still a chance here. Oh, that was clever. That was Harlem Globetrotter stuff. And Kevin Iroh, this is great from Iroh. A brilliant run from the New Zealander. Kevin Iroh scores a quite sensational try.
And in second place, Bob Grogan, Halifax versus Castlewood, a result of good backing up.
Midway through the first half, only 4 points on the board, and they've gone to Halifax, who are coming forward with Bell and with Holiday once more, and there could be an overlap on the right. Good chances here as Wilkinson shows a good turn of speed, cuts inside, gives the pass away. Bob Grogan's over!
But my choice for first position, Gary Mercer, Bradford Northern versus Wigan.
The mump is broken through the middle. Now has he got the pace to go all the way? Iroh's coming across. Surely there should be a try for Mercer as he cuts inside. There are so many options here. It's finally gone out to Simpson. He's now he's gone back to Mercer, and Bradford are going to score in the corner.
It came as my number one choice for positional awareness after breaking the defence, good backing up, excellent passing, and most of all, a result of marvellous teamwork.
And that try by Gary Mercer proved a worthy winner, and the winning entry came from a Bradford Northern supporter, Sheila Hutchinson, who's here with her family. Many congratulations, Sheila.
Thank you.
And your prize, 4 tickets for the Premiership final and a bottle of bubbly, and appropriately to be presented to you by Bradford Northern's captain, Paul Harkin.
Congratulations, Sheila.
Thank you, Paul.
And hopefully, fingers crossed, we'll be at Old Trafford with you.
Yes, we'll see each other, eh? Yeah. Make a date. Okay.
Paul, thank you very much indeed. Our congratulations, of course, to the Hutchinsons. And that really is where we must end it. It's the end not only of the Stones Bitter Championship season, but also of the Scrum Down series. We'd like to remind you of some of the moments we've shown during the series that show how rugby league is not only a game of great skill and endeavour and commitment, but also a game with lots of fun. From all of us here, from the Hutchinsons, from Paul Harkin, and all of us on the Yorkshire Television team, a very good night to you.
Sorry, Ellery, but it's reached a sort of a situation where we can't turn back, and Graham's not going to consider you, so in the future better be with another club.
Ellery has his hour, they're not going to stop him.
Probably a dream, but there's not a lot wrong with dreams.
It has to be, you know, we've been playing well, you know, like Sean's got an unfortunate injury, same ankle as like what I have, and but you know, the lads are, you know, confident in the, you know, they know what they've got to do. They've got to get out there and tackle Widnes, put Widnes down, stop Widnes from throwing the ball a bit. Widnes have got bags of pace, so you know, we know what we've got to do, and Graham Lowe's drilled into him, and hopefully, you know, they'll do it for the 80 minutes.
Now Tony Myler's also got to sit out and watch this from an injured position. Tony, do you think the Wigan injuries will help Widnes today?
Obviously, the injuries that have happened out at Wigan are going to help us, especially two players, centre field, with Sean and Andy missing. Hopefully, we can capitalise on that. They've obviously not got the same play organisers in there, so hopefully, we'll be able to take advantage of it.
Well, let's pick up that Wigan team news. Joe Lydon is back in the centre. Ellery Hanley reverts to stand-off. And with both Andy and Sean Edwards out with ankle injuries, the versatile Jed Byrne gets the vital role at scrum half.